Oh my God, it's cold. But I guess that means the volume gonna be good because I have my mic inside my sweater. But I ain't gonna be out here long now. So these are some starts. I'll figure out where to put them or not. I'm gonna take this. I'm either gonna put Tupac or Spin in it for the winter. I need to repot these if possible. Ooh, they've been annihilated. I don't know why I think that just because the temperatures drop that we don't have a last bout of thirsty cabbage worms that's going to come through. But they have. I think the sugar beets probably fooled me because look at these things. They never get, they're like damage resistant. I don't know. When I discover something that's been around like this and something that solves a simple problem that no one knows or uses, I'm convinced that it was by design and that there's a reason we don't know about these simple things. But anyway, these are a couple of carrots that I didn't have the guts to throw away as I thinned them, so I just stuck them in this little pot that I knew they didn't have room to grow in. So let's see, y'all want to, let's see how they look. Let's see, shall we? Little bitty carrots grew in there. Little balls of carrots, little carrot balls. Oh my! Oh, y'all can't even see. Little carrot balls. One of them is perfectly round. Oh my God, that's so cute. But honey, y'all know me. I can't do all this greens for this little thing. Mm-mm. Some of y'all be buying carrots that grow like that. Those little fingerling carrots. Girl, no. I need some food. That's why I'm going in for food. My kahunas are flowering. I'm letting them do some. Hopefully, I'll get some string beans from them. These as well. Looks like I probably won't from my snow peas. And that's okay. That's okay. We're gonna make it. Damn, all that fell down there. Okay, all right, I could probably reach down and get this whole thing. Ain't nothing but an animal did that. I'm gonna get Mister to get those things. Here's Maureen, she's the last one. I took the other one indoors. These, as you can see, are garlic. I thought I could cut those greens off like I do onions, but I don't think it works like that for garlic. I think you have to let them do what they do. I am going to pull up the herbs I have in there and put them all in a planter indoors and see what I can do with them. And then replace all these spaces with more garlic because the grocery stores are all of a sudden claiming to be that they don't have garlic in stock. It's crazy some of the stuff that they are claiming that they don't have in stock, y'all. It's very interesting. Anyway, there's kahuna again. Here is a hazel. I have three hazels now. I have one on each end. There's Rolona. That's where the yellow watermelon came from that we tasted for breakfast, really. There's Hazel. She's ready to pick a few leaves though. Hazel here as well. It does not have harvestable leaves though, but I might pick these damaged ones off and let the rest do what it do or see what it do. I still have these carrots. I'm going to continue to use them for storage until it gets super duper cold, and then I'm going to gradually harvest them as time goes on. I'm just going to continue to harvest these sugar beet greens over the course of the winter because I think that's how they work. I think you can leave them in the ground like that. And it looks like they might be more durable than spinach and chard and everything put together. So what I'm going to do is continue to grow them and let them sit in over winter and see how they work, because if they do, and I suspect they will, I'm just going to grow sugar beets and leave them in the ground to use their greens for 18 months to 2 years at a time, and then replant them every other year as a 2 year perennial. So yeah, but these carrots are doing another round. They're really beefing up right now while it's cold, so I'm gonna let them, and I'm gonna use the soil in the beds for storage, because I don't have the refrigerator room. And even if I did, I like using, y'all know me, I like using the plant for storage, except when you can't, like in the case of okra, which have to be harvested as soon as it's ready. But yeah, I have my four collards back here, 1, 2, 3, 4, with Hazel in the middle there. She's turning purple because it's getting cooler out. There's my last Rika, which was just starting to blush before it got cold. I might leave her out one more week, and then I'm going to empty the whole pot. This pot needs to be emptied. I'm going to try and get Mr. to do that. These two, as well as the melon pots. There are the two other melons. One is split, but I'm gonna go get the other one and take it indoors, harvest it and take it indoors. My snow pea, which are not flowering. What the hell? Violas are happy with the temperature drop. They're looking all velvety. This is Bina. I actually took all of her side branches to start new plants. So they're preparing to root right now inside. Oh, purple sprouting broccoli. We're gonna see what this does, because it has begun to flourish with the temperature drops. Y'all know I wasn't even getting leaves, and the leaves I was getting were annihilated. So I think I might harvest these outer leaves and just to see what it's gonna prompt the middle to do in the cold. Ooh, that wind, oh my God. See, here's the, this bed, the well bed. It looks bare as hell because I've pulled everything except for this one little spinach here. There's a sugar beet I replanted over here. I put one back there. What is that? One of the sprouting broccoli. It didn't have anybody's roots, so I'm gonna see what it does if it reattaches. Here is the only snap pea that grew, so it's not climbing anything. Oh, here's the other sugar beet. Are there two? Is that two of them? Here's a mulberry that I'm leaving for next year. The birds planted a bunch of those in here, but I just decided to let those two do a little something and see if I get a few mulberries next year. Here's the brick bed. The sugar beets and the center shard doing amazing. Look at that center shard there. Boom. It's like, harvest me, harvest me. I am. I'm gonna. Maybe today. Maybe tomorrow. My thick viola. I wonder if I want to take that indoors and try my luck. I don't know. We'll see. Here's another one I put over here. A few of my kahunas did come up. I had one, two, how many? Four. Four that came up. But I went ahead and I planted lettuce all throughout the center of this bed. And yeah, these are the carrots that are still growing. I put purple sprouting broccoli to grow in the middle of both. I put of each of these cages on either side. Hazel, sugar beet in the middle. Moringa is done. It's a wrap. Verbena, done. It's a wrap. I should pull those, but I'm not going. I want to see what they're going to do. Look how nice and red those stalks have gotten in this cold weather. Yes, ma'am. Same with this one. And this one is regrowing. Because y'all remember an animal came and served me a bit of destruction on that. So, I'm going to go in. Ooh, okay. Now I'm going to finish putting away groceries.
This is what I'm going to move. You can see it very well today in the sunlight. I'm going to go ahead and move this back under direct light because the leaves are doing okay and it's surviving. It's doing well. But the flowers have all dropped off. And it apparently needs a little more warmth to keep its flowers. I've taken all of my sugar cane and put them in a bigger vase. And I wanted to put it in a clear one.
so that I could see the roots forming, possibly, hopefully. And I cleaned this water out before I re-put them in here because it stinks. But I like how the water covers up more of the stalk. So we'll see. I think they sit in the water. They say just leave it sitting in the water for however long. In my case, I'm going to leave it in here for months, hopefully over the winter. And then they'll be ready to be planted out next spring. But, you know, I probably could just bring them. I'll figure something out. So this, I still need to get this lamb's quarters, who is really sad in here. This is still doing okay. See little gnats in here, so I need to do a little alcohol dusting. These are leaves from the Jamaican cherry that I brought in inside. It was looking real sad real fast in front of this window. It's my yoga mat. And I had it on this saucer here, plant saucer. But it was giving up is what it was giving. Hey girl. Hey pretty girl. Hey pretty girl. You're so pretty. Look at you. Look at you. So pretty. So her pattern came on through, and she does look mostly tabby, to tell you the truth, but she has all the qualities of the Maui wanted. And she's still just as beautiful. Oh yeah, there was a post of a young couple, and the guy had brought his girlfriend a kitten to help with her anxiety. And man, the scene was exactly like with Mr. and I, except I think I cried more. And it was exactly like it. And I showed him, and he was like, yo, because when she reached for the kitten, it looked exactly like she looked when we got her. She was so little and so cute. Except I think ours was even tinier. It was so cute. I about broke down again watching them. It was so cute, such a young couple. And for him to do that for his girlfriend was very precious. Very precious to see a young man prioritizing his girlfriend's mental wellness. It was really beautiful. And I hope that her baby gives her as much joy as ours gives us. This thing probably hasn't had water in I don't know when, but that's on Mr. Bum, 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 bum. This is the setup that's a little remote control car. That's for her as well, but Mr. bought that. Yeah, this is a little setup that her grandma and auntie bought her. Isn't that nice? And they also got her a couple of other little toys. Oh my God, I was so moved. Because our babies are the only grandkids that they're getting from us. So they treat it as such. And I am so appreciative of that respect for our baby. I'm so appreciative. Okay, I'm not going to cry. I'm not going to cry. I'm not going to cry. Amaranth, look at that. If that don't look like a beautiful red tree right now. Really pretty. I might lift it up onto the porch and keep it on the porch. Herb planter. I think it's getting a little too cold for everything. You can see the cilantro is blushing on its edges, and the oregano. The oregano is actually surviving. And the violas, of course, love the cool weather. I did take some branches of the verbena over here so that I can try to grow them. I've failed repeatedly growing verbena indoors, but I want to, you know, maybe potentially grab some starts and get them started, because that's one of the things that are difficult to come by, and I want to add that to my list of
of trees that I and bushes that I sell. I said that like I have a big ass list. It's only a few, but I want to add that to the list all the same. This walkway is, we got to do something next, something more organized next year, because these weeds and it's, and I don't like the way hostas, I know everybody likes hostas because they're low maintenance, but I don't like the way hostas look during their off season. I don't like it. And the sorrel is a no. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know that I wouldn't just like a bunch of violas filling up that area. Like, why not? But we'll see. I know that spotted spurge is a no, and that's not what I'm trying to have for ground cover at all. But we're gonna get that together next year. Ain't that right, baby? Ain't that right, baby? Ain't that right, Pudding Pop? Aww. Aww. I love you, baby girl. Aww, I love you. You better not. Her thumbnail hurts. Your thumbnail fucking hurts. Let me see that thing. She know I was gonna smack her. She feels the energy. She feels the energy like just a second before you do something. Like she can feel just before you grab for her, like seconds before, like not seconds, maybe one full second or a half a second. But she can feel like if I'm about to reach her down and grab her right now, she can feel it. If I'm about to pick her up and she's okay with it, she's probably okay with it right now. But sometimes when I call myself gonna reach down and snatch her, she'll take off like. Okay. Let me finish putting these groceries away.